Hello everybody and welcome back to another video. Now in today's episode, we're going to be talking all about ChromeOS Flex, a topic that has been heavily suggested by you guys out there. I mean, I have received countless emails and DMs about this, and so that's great. We're going to be taking a look at this today and checking it out and seeing what it's all about. Now, for those who don't know, ChromeOS Flex is a new version of ChromeOS designed specifically to run on non-ChromeOS hardware, hardware that did not originally ship with ChromeOS. Now, if that sounds familiar to you guys who watched this video that I made back in 2020 on Neverware's Cloud Ready, that's because Google actually purchased that company. So Cloud Ready or Neverware is now a part of Google, and ChromeOS Flex is the result of that buyout. Now, of course, this did raise a couple of concerns about what's going to happen to the Cloud Ready operating system itself, but as of right now, you can still download the home edition of that for free, though we're not sure if that's going to change in the future, though I would suspect that it will, since Google is going to want to be pushing ChromeOS Flex. Now, of course, this is going to do the exact same thing that Cloud Ready did, but it's just neat to see Google officially supporting it now and giving it the ChromeOS name. Now, of course, with any video like this, I had to ask myself the very important question of what computer am I going to install this operating system on. So I went into my realm of computers and pulled out an old friend that you guys probably haven't seen in a while, the low-end Gateway Walmart laptop. Yes, this right here, I did a video on this whole fiasco back in 2020 as well, and it's quite the story because this right here is a Gateway laptop in name only. It is not sold, manufactured, or supported by Gateway whatsoever, and it's just a rebranded Chinese laptop that you can also get at Walmart under a different brand name. I mean, there are some differences, but it's essentially the same machine, and it runs Windows 10, but barely. I mean, it barely meets the minimum system requirements, and it runs extremely poorly as a result. So let's install ChromeOS Flex on it and see if it makes the thing actually usable. So installing ChromeOS Flex is extremely straightforward because it's the same process you would go through to create recovery media for a Chromebook. And that's by using the Chromebook Recovery Utility, fittingly named, right? Which you can download in the Chrome Web Store. Now, I am using Microsoft Edge here, but since it is Chromium-based, I can just use it in here and add it to Microsoft Edge. And so we're going to get started. Now, you need to have an 8 gig or larger USB flash drive or an SD card. I'm using a 16 gig USB flash drive. So right here is where you would type in the model number of your Chromebook, or you can select a model from a list. Now, we're going to have to do this because the manufacturer in this case is going to be ChromeOS Flex, which is right down here, Google ChromeOS Flex, and then the product, there's only this one developer unstable version here because this is still currently in development. This has not been officially released yet. It's going to ask us to select our USB drive. We're going to go with that 14, well, it's a 16 gig, but Windows sees it as 14.6 gig flash drive, and we'll hit on continue. And we will click on create now, and it will erase the USB drive and copy over the necessary files to it. All right, so we're off to a great start here. It's been, let's say, like 5 minutes or so, and we have not progressed at all, which is mildly concerning. And if we go into File Explorer here, the USB drive is still empty. There's nothing copied over to it. It's still mounted to the system. So I'm wondering if you need to have Google Chrome proper. I don't see why, because Microsoft Edge is Chromium based. I could just do this entire process on another computer, but I mean, I wanted to do everything on this laptop itself. So, okay, it doesn't seem like we're getting anywhere. I'm just gonna cancel it from here. And let's just go to, let's close out of this. We will add the extension and it works. Okay, so yeah, you need to do it through Google Chrome. All right, so we're all set. We've got the recovery utility saying that it's finished, that we're done. So we're going to click here to get out of it. And we're now going to restart our computer, and we're just gonna, in Windows 10 here, we're going to open up the power options here. And we're going to hold the shift key on update and restart. And that will bring us into the advanced boot options menu here, since this is a UEFI based firmware. And so we're gonna go down to use a device, and we're going to select the only device there, which is the USB drive. And that should boot us into the ChromeOS installer. So it's gonna reboot the system here. Got that good old Gateway logo. There we go. Oh, check that out. Now, what I find interesting is I saw some images of this setup process, and it actually still says cloud ready. There are some references to cloud ready that have not been changed yet. And so that is yet another sign that this is not only a developer beta, but also based on the existing cloud-ready operating system that has just been rebranded. But Google has obviously done their thing to it, Googleified it, put in the proper Google Chrome instead of Chromium, and all that jazz. So yeah, here we are on the, well, we're on just the blank screen right now. You got the shutdown options and the volume options and everything in the bottom right. And now we're at a black screen, which is even more exciting. I wonder what it's doing right here. I'm starting to get a little concerned here because this should definitely not be happening. I cannot interact with the system at all, and I think we're just gonna do a force reset here. Okay, so this is the screen we got to last time. I can move the mouse around, and we can... Okay, so we can click down here, and I think it's freezing up, yeah, because the mouse cursor, like, I'm moving the mouse right now, and it is not responding. So I think the entire system just locked up. One thing that I probably should have mentioned earlier is there is an official compatibility list on the Google support pages for ChromeOS Flex. I didn't really think we'd run into a problem because this does meet the minimum hardware requirements and all of that. There's just certain things that are not going to function properly, like not every component in this computer is guaranteed to work properly with ChromeOS Flex. For example, the touchscreen and Bluetooth, those might not work, and I guarantee they're not going to work here. But apparently we can't even get the installer to load up, so let me just go and double check some things. Okay, so we're back, and I did a little bit of research. Turns out this is a very common issue with the current build of ChromeOS Flex. This is a known bug, and the best advice that people have been giving on the subreddit is try turning it off and back on again, and eventually it'll work. Some people have said that it's a display issue, use an external monitor, but I mean you see it's freezing. If the system itself is freezing up, that's not gonna change anything. So I boot into the BIOS here so we can change the boot option because I don't wanna have to boot into Windows 10 and go through what we went through last time. So we're going to up boot option 1. Okay, another suggestion has appeared. Turning on legacy mode in the BIOS. Alright, so we're gonna go to the compatibility support module, enable that, and change boot option filter to legacy only. Well, perhaps that and disabling the trusted platform module will help. And we're moving around, and did the same thing. Oh no. Alright, so let's try a different system. So we're just going to set the gateway laptop aside here for now. And I'm going to bring in my Acer laptop. This is my old laptop that I was using before I switched to the MacBook Pro. Now you watch, this is going to work totally fine on here. It's going to boot up, and I'm not going to want to install it because I don't want to overwrite the Windows 10 installation on here. I don't want to bother with really dual booting it either. Why I wanted to use this gateway machine. This is another one of those projects that I was like, you know what? This will be a nice little video to do. We can take a look at ChromeOS Flex. We can explore it and have a grand old time. And of course, we run into all sorts of issues. But hey, again, this is what happens when, you watch an MJD video. It's also what happens when you use developer software. Okay, so here's the moment of truth. We're moving the mouse around. And it seems to be lasting a little longer here. And it works! Of course it works! On the one machine I don't want to actually install it on. So, okay. Well, I guess Windows 10 is remaining on this laptop for the time being. And I'm going to go and grab another system that I don't really mind wiping the hard drive on, and we'll install Cloud Ready. See, this is what I was talking about. It says Cloud Ready 2.0, even though this is now called ChromeOS Flex, so kind of find that interesting. But anyways, let's go ahead and power this off, get a new system, and check it out. Remember this? So yeah, this machine right here is definitely not going to meet all of ChromeOS Flex's minimum system requirements because it is from like 2008. We're moving the mouse around, we can go down to our settings here, we're not connected, and it... Oh man. This right here is MIME and it's doing the same thing, okay. Okay, so we're back finally. It's been about an hour, I think, since the last clip, maybe an hour and a half. And I've been just testing this on as many laptops as I could find. And you guys saw some of that footage, some of it you didn't see, these two MacBooks here. I mean, I've done multiple attempts here trying to get this to work. And this Acer laptop is the only one that it actually fully boots into the installer on. And of course, it's the one machine that I said I did not want to mess with because this is my old personal laptop and I still have some data on it. I'm fully aware that I could have just repartitioned the drive, but I just would rather not do that because I don't feel like messing with the boot manager and all that jazz. So instead, what I did, because I'm committed to getting ChromeOS Flex installed on something, is I took out the hard drive and I put in a blank hard drive, an SSD actually. That's why we have this screen right here, because there is currently no bootable device. So we are going to pop in our USB stick. One of the other things I did is I reformatted this and went through the ChromeOS Flex or just the ChromeOS Restore wizard again, and that didn't change anything. So we're gonna pop this into a USB port on here, and we are going to restart. We'll just have to do a force restart here, and it should find that USB device. Now, this is, as I have mentioned already, an ongoing problem, and it very well could be fixed by the time that this video goes out in the next release of ChromeOS Flex. This is a pretty widespread issue from what I've seen. There's a lot of people on Reddit talking about this within the last couple days. The posts are fairly new. And there's one guy, one of my favorite posts, is that there's a guy who's been trying to install ChromeOS Flex on a fleet of laptops, and this problem will just happen intermittently. So honestly, it could happen on this laptop right now. Let's just hope it doesn't. Let me hope I just didn't jinx myself here. Oh, I'm getting anxious here because it's like, I think this model, let me just look up on the official supported device list here. So this right here is an Acer Aspire E15. The exact model number is the E5-575G-5341. A lot of fives in there, right? And it is not on the ChromeOS Flex supported devices list, which just means that Google has not tested it. It doesn't mean that it's not going to work. And the fact that we're here on the setup screen is a great sign because, again, all those other machines, we didn't get to this point. So we're gonna get started. And this is where you have the option of either installing it or trying it first. If you wanted just to boot off of the USB drive and try out ChromeOS Flex, you can do that. Welcome to Cloud Ready 2.0, fast, secure, and effortless. Oh, isn't that beautiful? And, okay, next. Okay, that was, oh my gosh, it's freezing up again. Are you kidding me? Oh my gosh, I actually had hope that was going to work. So it looped us back to the beginning of the setup, and then it just locked up. All right, we're just gonna turn it off. But that's good that we got to that point. Let's try it again here. I mean, this is just not my day, man. I mean, I woke up thinking, I'm gonna record this video, it'll be pretty simple, then I can move on to another video project that I want to do. And no, that's not really happening. But okay, this is good. So we didn't get to this point before. Before starting, make sure you have a backup of your data. Okay, install and erase hard disk. Oh, and this is the thing too. It apparently doesn't give you the option to partition your, or to, does it really not give you? Yeah, I guess it doesn't give you the option to partition your drive or like install it on a specific partition because this drive has multiple partitions on it. Yeah, it's just gonna overwrite the entire drive, which honestly, now that I think about it, isn't really a big deal at all. Oh look, the installation's complete, that's nice. Your device will shut down in 48 seconds. Okay, so we'll just let it time out there. It's honestly not a huge deal that you can't configure the partitions because, I mean, if you're installing ChromeOS Flex on a laptop to convert it into a Chromebook, you're gonna probably be using it as a Chromebook. I mean, it doesn't really make sense to dual boot it with Windows because if you just want to browse the web, you can do that from Windows. The only reason to be installing ChromeOS is like in the case of the Gateway laptop here, Windows just runs so poorly and you just want to browse the web and use the device as a Chromebook, as a lightweight laptop. And so, yeah, I mean, that's what this is for. There's certainly scenarios where, you know, you would want to do that if you were trying it out, for instance, but, I mean, you could just do that in a virtual machine, right? There's no need to, like, section off a partition on your hard drive for ChromeOS. But anyway, so it's restarting here, and there we go. We're doing our first boot here. Welcome to, this looks eerily familiar. Okay, I was gonna say, like, please do not tell me that something screwed up. And this is where you have to sign in. We'll just browse as a guest for now. So we'll click that button down there just to launch into ChromeOS, and there we go. You're browsing as a guest. Isn't that, this is like the most excited I've ever been to see ChromeOS, like after going through this ridiculously long video trying to get it to install. I've tried freaking 5 laptops. So I think the first thing I'm going to do is quote unquote enable Linux on the Chromebook. I think that's what they call it. It's not really worded well because, I mean, it is based off of Linux. Linux is a feature. Oh, get ready for all the Linux people to be pissed off at like that wording. Linux isn't a feature, it's an op. Yeah, okay, we know. But that's the way Google words it here. It lets you develop software using your Chromebook. You can install Linux, command line tools, da da da. So I think you have to be signed in to do this. So, okay, so let's go to settings. And then let's go to advanced, and yeah, of course, now we have the developer options. Linux development enrollment, we're going to turn that on, put the username as Michael. Disk size recommended, that's fine. Installing Linux, okay. ChromeOS update required. Oh, okay, nearly up to date. Okay, was that just released today? Hang on a second, there's no, because that was the late, unless the installer wasn't updated. Error installing Linux, oh lord. Okay, error starting Penguin container, launching VM shell failed. Oh yeah, developer mode is currently not available in Flex. There you go. That's that's as simple as it is. It is currently not supported by Google. So yeah, hey, that doesn't surprise me because ChromeOS Flex, this is definitely 100% still in development. I mean, there is no doubt about it. It's probably going to be a little while until it fully gets released, which is good because you want to make sure all these bugs and problems are fixed. You want to make sure every device that is officially supported. Of course, to be fair to Google, none of these devices that I've tested today are officially supported. Well, yeah, there you have it, guys. That is the long journey I took to get ChromeOS Flex installed on a laptop, and well, I'm just glad that we got it installed. What can I say? I mean, this was a long time coming. This video was way longer than I wanted it to be, but hey, hopefully you guys enjoyed it. If you did, be sure to give it a thumbs up, get subscribed down below, turn on those notifications, all that good stuff. And as always, I want to thank you all so much for watching, and I will see you in the next video.